So my name is Juan José García Machado. I'm a professor of finance at the University of Huelva in Spain. And I presented an article on a PLS model on light trading, including a moderating effect and assessing the overall model fit measures. So this presentation had been today, this morning, and it took about 25 minutes. So we carry out a study among online investors, and we conduct a survey to more than 240 people, and through investment strategy forum on internet website. It's an internet website, and then people have to respond to this survey, and then this survey includes some items or indicators for some latent variable. So we can distinguish in the proposed PLS model on light trading between the structural model, with draw the relationship between the constructor and the measurement model for each latent variable. So in the inner model, we have two relationship between exogenous and endogenous latent variables, like, for example, knowledge quality, trading frequency, portfolio performance, experience at online trading, economy trust based, also share vision, personal outcomes expectation, and so on. So we design several measurement models, and then the first step we follow is to assess the quality and the validity and the reliability of this measurement model. And the second step was to see the size and the strong of the relationship between latent variables, see the pack coefficient between the variables, and then doing run algorithm procedures called PLS algorithm to check the statistical significance for the pack coefficients. We did a bootstrap proceeding, and then our result yield for seven hypotheses that we did, the three of them was verified at 99 level of significance. Two of them were significant at 95 level, percent level, and one was verified at 19 level of significance. So only one relationship between knowledge quality and trading frequency is not significant. So after analyzing this proposed model, we continue with assessing the overall model fit using some measure recommended by researchers. And we found that the model is fit for standardized root mean residual criteria and also for geodesic discrepancy, unfit for Euclidean discrepancy. So the last but not least step in this study we conduct was assess the moderating effect. So for do that, we include a new variable, a moderator variable called income and financial wealth, with two indicators. The first indicator were monthly income for the household, and the second one was the level of wealth for this household. And then we introduce an interaction term. So the interaction term path coefficient was negative, as we suppose. That means a negative relationship between higher level of income and financial wealth, with the relationship between trading frequency and portfolio performance. That is, when the income level is high, the relationships between trading frequency and portfolio performance is low. So for rich people, this relationship is not so important, as important as other investors with lower income and financial wealth levels. And finally, we presented our conclusion and implication, and we verified 6 of 7 hypotheses. We found that the path coefficient between the moderator variable was also significant. This is important to take into account for online investor see what is the experience as online trading, and also the economy based trust. Finally, we want to continue with our research, including new latent variables, and also taking into account formative measurement models.